Welcome back. This week, we're outside the continent and inside New York City, focused on Africa's influence abroad. It was ballet that first brought Ismail Kouyaté to the Big Apple. 4 years later, it's contemporary dance that's keeping him there. Along the way, the one constant has always been his connection to his West African roots. The sights of Brooklyn, the rhythm and beat of West Africa. At the Mark Morrison Dance Studio, Americans of all shapes and sizes line up and test out one of the latest cultural trends sweeping through the city, African dance classes. Gender and race don't seem to matter. Everyone is welcome.
It's such a great joy for me to come here and watch people go across the floor and have it be an elderly white woman and a young Asian man and a middle-aged black man. It just looks like Brooklyn. You know, it looks like where it's a reflection of where we live here.
It's not just the rhythm that's attracting crowds of dancers to this vibrant studio. It's also the teacher.
And 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1.
At 5'8", dance instructor Ismail Kouyaté offers contemporary dance moves with a West African twist and a big smile.
When I dance and when I hear that, the music and the drums are amazing. And I see all of these people in our class, I just get so many ideas and it makes me feel like I have a spirit inside me giving me all these ideas. So that's what I try to bring out in my students.
Well, Ismail's class is hot, very hot. I come here because this is my, like, breather from the world. It encloses me and embraces me and lets me just be me.
Students say Kouyaté teaches more than moves. His class offers an experience and a little glimpse of authentic African culture. Kouyaté spent most of his 28-year dance career on the stage. He started dancing at just 6 years old in his home country of Guinea. Over time, his talent flourished and Kouyaté became a stage sensation, sweeping up lead roles in the country's prestigious national ballet. But his talents weren't only displayed on stage. Guineans throw colorful dance parties called Dunduba to celebrate every occasion. At these festive gatherings, Kouyaté had a reputation for stealing the spotlight.
The first time I saw Ismail was in Guinea. And I remember I was at a Dunduba and Ismail came into the room and everyone like started whispering. They're like, it's Bonfils. That's his nickname, right? It's Bonfils. And he went in and he danced and it was amazing. And about 2 years later, I was taking a dance class in New York and he walked in and he was the teacher. I'm like, oh my God, it's that guy from Guinea.
Kouyaté toured New York 4 years ago with Guinea's National Ballet. He says he brought all his moves with him and he wants to share every step. Today he's teaching his class the Sofa, the dance of a warrior.
There's a reason and a purpose behind everything in the dance. There's a connection between the drums and the dance. Because unlike other styles of dance that have a count, African dance is rhythm. It's very rhythmic. So you have to pay attention because everything connects.
Like when I first started dancing and I saw people soloing, I'd always think that they were dancing to what the drummer was playing. And as time went on, I realized it's not what's happening. Really, the drummer is playing to what the dancer is dancing.
Americans are very curious and they want to learn a lot of different things. So when they see something like this dance that's very complicated and interesting, they want to learn it and they want to get better at it. It pleases me to be able to come here and be able to share this with Americans, to show them what I have to offer.
What Kouyaté has to offer is rhythm, grace, and skill. His quick moves landed him a role in the hit musical Fela. And he's not the only African dance teacher with a following. Since the 1990s, nearly 100 African dance classes have sprung up throughout New York City's boroughs. Since Fela hit Broadway last year, class sizes have grown even more.
We opened in 2001 and attendance has increased tenfold, and a lot of that is from the adult classes, particularly West African and Afro-Caribbean, for sure. We've had to move classes out of studios into larger studios because some weeks are more attended than others, but it's always growing every year.
One, two, three, and one.
With a stomp of a foot and the swing of a hip, Kuyate caters to his growing classes, and it's not easy. When his students master the moves, Kuyate turns the heat up a little higher.
It gives me the courage to bring them more intricate and more interesting dance. When I see that they are really understanding, it just makes me excited and want to give them more.
He sees dance as a way to connect.
We don't even, a lot of times, speak English together, but we are able to communicate. We are able to have this universal language and grow together. You know, when you leave there, you're in a different person. You're definitely a better person than when you walked in.
Before we're back in New York, we head to the DRC, where Simple Solution is helping to preserve a forest and a way of life. Then, cuts, culture, and conversation in Le Petit Senegal. Inside Africa returns after the break.